Now, let's discuss about feature extraction technique in natural language processing. What do you mean by feature extraction? Why is this important? We human beings understand raw text, that is, we understand several languages like English. What about machine? Is it able to understand our language? Obviously not. So, in machine learning, we must convert raw text into some matrix or vector representation. We extract features from the text and convert into the form that are processable by the machine. This is what feature extraction in natural language processing refers to. We have mainly two techniques of feature representation. That is, first bag of word and second TF-IDF representation. I will explain bag of word in this video and cover TF-IDF in the next one. So, what is bag of word representation? Bag of word refers to represent text in document term matrix. As I have already mentioned, this method convert our raw text into some vector or matrix representation. This method use concept of one-hot encoding. Do you heard this term before? Let me explain one-hot encoding from example. Suppose I have one text, honest person. And the index of honest is 1232 and person is 2567. Just assume it. Then in one-hot encoding, what we do is just place one in the matrix where honest is located, that is at index 1232. And put zero in all other place of that matrix. And we do same thing for person, that is fill one in the matrix where person is located, that is at index 2567 and put zero in all other place of that matrix. This is one-hot encoding. Do you get it? I hope yes. Bag of word is similar like this, but not exactly. Now let's see how we represent features in bag of word. Let us assume one example. There are five sentences in front of your screen. We want this sentence to be represented in bag of word model. So, what we do is we count each word in the particular sentence. And place their number of occurrence in the corresponding location of the document term matrix. We have features like honest, person, baby, boy, we, human, beings, are. These are features. Now, we count each word and place their number of occurrence in the matrix. Like in first sentence, honest and person occur one time, so place one in the corresponding location. In the last sentence, human occur twice, so we put two in the matrix. Then fill all other place by zero. This is our final bag of word. So, in bag of word, we represent raw text into document term matrix. Do you get it? Suppose in the last sentence, we have different form of human. That is, one capitalize, and other not. If this is the case, then we need two features to represent the same term. But we don't want this, right? We want to have less number of features and still get better result. So, the best method is to convert all into lowercase before we apply bag of word model. Now, let's do code. As usual, first of all I have to import several libraries. I have imported NLTK. Then RE regular expression. Also I have imported stop words to remove all stop words of English language and WordNet lemmatizer to apply lemmatization in my text. We have all discussed about this term before. I have one paragraph with three sentences, I guess. I have to make an object of WordNet lemmatizer. Then tokenize my paragraph into sentences using nltk.sent_tokenize. I have one empty list, final underscore text. I will use for loop to iterate over all the sentences in a paragraph. Next I will use resub. Sub means substitute and this caret symbol refer except. That means substitute all the symbol except small and capital A to Z by space. Like replace number by space. Other special symbol by space. After this step, we will have pure character from A to Z. And then convert uppercase letter to lowercase. Then split each word and put them inside list. Then I have used list comprehension to apply lemmatization to those word which are not stop words of English language. I have explained about lemmatization and stop words in my previous video. I hope you have watched all those. So that it will be easy for you to understand what we are doing right now. Next, convert list into string. And then append each converted sentence into the final underscore text list. Let me execute this function. And then let me print the result. You can see. All the unwanted symbol get removed and also there are no any stop words. If the words can be lemmatized, then definitely the word get converted into lemma. This is our final text. Now, we have to represent our final text into bag of word representation. For this, we have to import count vectorizer from sklearn. If you didn't install sklearn before, you can use pip to install this package. Just type pip install scikit-learn in the terminal. Then create an object of count vectorizer. Finally, pass our final underscore text into fit underscore transform. If I place cursor in fit underscore transform, it display definition of that term. This convert our raw text into document term matrix, as I have already explained. And this .toArray, convert our matrix into array. Then print the final result. Let me execute this. So, this is final bag of word representation. You can check the output by yourself. In the last sentence, we have one word that repeat four times. What is that? I think. Like. This is how you can convert raw text into document term matrix. Now, I have one assignment for you. Are you ready? Why is this model named bag of word? What are its limitations? If you are serious about learning NLP, just research about this. And put your answer in the comment section below. I want all of you to find the answer and add in the comment section. This is very important question. In interview also, there is more chance to ask this question. So research about this. I hope, I will get the answer from you. This much for this video. In the next video, I will discuss about TF-IDF model. Keep loving and keep supporting. Stay safe and keep learning.